Welcome student to my YouTube channel Bharat Chem Study. Today we are going to study about chapter Structure of Atom for plus 1 class. In this video part 7, we are going to arrange the subshells according to their energies, that is to understand how to write the electronic configuration, the Aufbau principle, N plus L rule, Pauli exclusion principle and Hund's rule for maximum multiplicity. So let's start with the topics. In previous classes, we have studied the electronic configurations as 2 in the first shell, 8 electron in the second shell and in the third shell also 8 electron. But after the discovery of orbitals and subshells, now we are going to study the electronic configuration in terms of subshells and orbitals. For that, we have to arrange the various orbitals and subshells in the increasing order of their energies to write the electronic configuration. The first rule which comes for arranging subshells says that higher the value of N for a subshell, higher will be its energy. So according to this rule, the increasing order of energies of various subshell would be 1s, because for it the value of N is 1, so it has least energy, then 2s, because for 2s N is equal to 2, and for 2p N is also again equal to 2, therefore 2s and 2p is having same energy. Then the higher energy is of 3s, for which the nth value is 3, which is equal to 3p and 3d, because for all these 3s, 3p and 3d, the value of n will be, so they must have same energies. And then the energy of 4s will be higher than 3, because it is having n value 4. So 4s, 4p and 4d also having the same value for n, that is 4, therefore they have same energies. But according to this arrangement, the energy of 2s and 2p, similarly 3s, 3p and 3d are coming same, which is creating a confusion that to which subshell electron will enter first in case of subshells with the same energy. In general, the electron first enter in the subshell of lower energy and then enter in the increasing order of energies. To simplify this problem, N plus L rule is introduced. Now the N plus L rule, according to this rule, higher is the value of N plus L, that is the principal quantum number and the azimuthal quantum number, higher is the energy of the subshell. Hence, according to this rule, the increasing order of energies of subshells is 1s, then 2s, because for 1s, N plus L value is equal to 1, and for 2s, N plus L value is equal to 2. Then 2p, which is having N plus L value equal to 3, and the energy of 2p is come equal to 3s, because for 3s also N plus L value is equal to 3. Then 2p and 4s is having higher energy, but they have same energy among themselves, because for 3p as well as 4s, the N plus L value is coming 4. Then the increasing order is 3d and 4p, which have same energy, because for both of them the N plus L value is coming same, that is equal to 5. But according to this rule also, 2p and 3s subshell have same energy, because both have N plus L value equal to 3, and 3p and 4s have same energy, as N plus L value for both of them is also equal to 4. In such cases of same N plus L value, this rule suggests that the subshell with higher value of N will have more energy if two subshells have same N plus L value. Hence, according to this amendment of this rule, the increasing order of energies of subshells become 1s, then 2s, then 2p, then 3s, because in case of 2p and 3s, the n plus value is same, but in case of 2p, the value of n will be 2, and in case of 3s, the value of n will be 3, therefore, the 2p has less energy than 3s. Further, the increasing order of energy is 3p, then 4s. In both these cases, the n plus value is same, but because 3p is having n value 3 and 4 is having n value 4, therefore the energy of 3p is less than 4, then 3d, then 4p, then 5s, then 4d, then 5p, then 6s, then 4f and 5d and 6p, so on. So this is the correct increasing order of various subshells and the correct electronic configuration in terms of subshells and orbitals. So the correct increasing order of energy of subshell will be written as 1s is having lower energy, then 2s, then 2p, then 3s, then 3p, then 4s, then 3d and so on. Here is a trick to learn this order in an easy way. So you have to write first of all the s orbital, first 1s, then 2s, then 3s, then 4s, then 5s, 6s and 7s like this. Then we know that p start from 2, so then we write the p orbitals in this way, 2p, 3p, 4p, 5p, 6p and up to 7p. Similarly, we know that the d orbitals start from third shell, therefore we will write the d subshells as 3d, 4d, 5d and 6d. And we know that f orbitals start from 4 and there are 2f orbitals, 4f and 5f. Now, we have to start with the 1s first, diagonally, then 2s, and then we will take 2 subshells, 2p and 3s diagonally, then 3p, 4s, then 3d, 4p, 5s, then 4d, 5p, 6s, and 4f, 5d, 6p, 7s, then this. So here we start from the backward up to arrow, then we again start from backward till arrow, then we again start from backward towards the arrow, then we again start from the backward towards the arrow. So the correct order will become 1s, then 2s, then 2p, 3s, then 3p and 4s, then 3d, 4p, 5s, and then 4d, 5p, 6s. In our study up to class plus 2, basically we are going to study the electronic configuration up to 3d only. And the electronic configuration can also be written in this form, 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, etc. But this is the easiest way to learn for the beginners in plus 1 class. So after knowing the correct order of orbitals, some important points and rule must be studied before filling the electronic configuration. First, that s orbital can be represented as by a box or by a circle. It may be 1s, it may be 2s, but if it is s subshell, that shape remains the same. The value of n may be different, but shape remains the same here. P subshell contain 3 orbitals and can be represented by 3 boxes touching each other or by 3 circles touching each other. All these 3 orbitals touching each other because they have same energy and are called degenerate orbitals. P subshell contain 5 orbitals and can be represented as the 7 boxes touching each other or by 7 circles touching each other. All these 5 d orbitals touching each other also because they have same energy and also called degenerate orbitals because of their same energies. Always remember, an orbital that is a box or a circle can have only 2 electrons. So we can fill only 2 electrons within a box. Now, we are going to study about certain rules for filling the electronic configuration. The first rule is Pauli exclusion principle. It states that no 2 electrons in an atom can have same value for all the 4 quantum number. That means that within a same atom, no 2 electron will have the same address, that is the same number of all the 4 quantum numbers. This principle is called exclusion principle because it excludes the possibility of having same value of all the 4 quantum number for any 2 electrons. One more statement for the Pauli principle or Pauli exclusion principle will be that an orbital can accommodate maximum of 2 electrons and that must be of opposite spin. So it also excludes the possibility of more than 2 electrons within the orbital. That's why this principle also be called as Pauli exclusion principle. So from this principle we can understand an orbital which is represented by a box or a circle can have maximum of 2 electrons and the spin of those 2 electrons must be opposite like this. So this is an orbital which is represented by a box. It will have maximum of 2 electrons according to Pauli principle, one upward and the another electron according to this principle must be downward. That means both of these electrons must have opposite spins as shown. Of Bohr principle, this principle states that electrons tend to occupy the orbital of minimum energy and orbitals with lower energy are filled first, then the electron enters into higher orbitals only when the lower energy orbital is completely filled. For example, if we have to fill 4 electrons in the electronic configuration, then electron will enter in 1s orbital first and then will go to next, that is 2s orbital, only when the 1s orbital is fully filled, that it is having the two electrons as shown. So here is the 1s orbital and here is the 2s orbital. So if we are having 4 electrons, first of all we have to fill the first 1s orbital and it must contain only 2 electrons. So we will put 2 electrons here, and only when 1s orbital is fully filled, then we will enter the next electrons to the next orbitals like this. And they must have opposite spins. Now Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, it states that the electron pairing will not take place in the orbitals of same energy until each orbital is singly first. So this rule is meant for those orbitals which have having same energy, like in case of p orbitals and in case of d orbitals and f orbitals. For example, in case of p, d and f subshells, all the orbitals in them have same energy. In such case, each orbital is first singly filled, and if then more electron is there, then pairing of electron will take place as shown. So let's take p orbitals. It may be 2p, 3p or 4p. Value of n may be different. So if we have to fill the electron must be filled first singly, and if more electrons are there, then we have to start with the pairing like this. Similarly, in case of d orbital, either 3d, 4d or 5d, the electron pairing will first, in case of these orbital, we will first fill one electron to each orbital, and then after the filling of each orbital singly, then we will start pairing from the beginning like this. After studying all the rules and about shells, that is n subshells and orbitals, we will understand that s subshell or s orbital can have maximum of 2 electrons. That means the first shell is having 2 electrons. P subshell consists of 3 orbitals and can have maximum of 6 electrons, 2 electrons in each p orbitals. D subshell consists of 5 orbitals, can have maximum of 10 electrons, 2 electrons in each d orbital. So that means S subshell can have maximum of 2 electrons, P subshell can have maximum of 6 electrons, and D subshell can have maximum of 10 electrons. Study all the rules and important topics studied in this video. Do practice of correct order of electronic configuration as discussed. In the next video, we will study how to write electronic configuration of different elements as well as ion. Please like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.